we're talking about a three-phase half-wave rectifier, and you can see this circuit is shown here. We have three input voltages, and they're all phase shifted by 120 degrees. And then we have each of them connected with a diode to the output here. So this is a circuit, and we're going to go through the basic modes of operation. First, we need to understand how the diodes interact in this combination. So we're going to start with an example. Let's say we have three different voltages here. A is 10, B is 5 volts, and C is 1 volt. And we have these three diodes, and we're not sure we have to figure out which voltage is on the output. Well, let's make just a guess. So let's say that this is on, this one here. So this diode is on, D3, and so current goes through here. Because the diode is on, the voltage drop is 0, so that means over here is 1 volt. Okay, that looks good. But then let's look at this second diode, diode 2. Because 5 volts is higher than that, higher than 1, that also means that this one is also on. And the third one, actually this one, 10 volts, would also be on. So all three of these diodes would be on at the same time. But that can't happen because Kirchhoff's voltage law says that one node can only have one voltage. But if all three of these diodes are on, it has to be simultaneously 1 volt, 5 volt, and 10 volts. That cannot happen. So this is not what is going to happen. What will actually happen is only the highest voltage will go through. So this current will go through, which means that the voltage on this side is 10 volts. And if we look at the other two diodes, this is 5 volts on this side, 10 on this side. That's reverse bias, so it's blocking. That's correct. That looks good. And the same here, 10 volts on this side, 1 volt on this side. This diode will block. And so only the highest voltage will go through, be seen on the other side of the diodes in this configuration. We have the three-phase half-wave rectifier here, and we want to look at break down the signal. So what we're going to do is look at just this first region here. And we see that blue is A, so that's A here. B is going to be red, so that's the one down here. And C is going to be green, that's the one here. So during this interval, A is the highest voltage. The current will go through A here, through our load, and come back through neutral here and complete the circuit. So during this stage, when A is the highest, this is the current path through our rectifier. Now we'll look at stage two. And this is where C, the green, becomes the highest voltage, so from here to here. And A and B are both lower voltages. So since C is the highest, the current will go through C, through diode 3, through the load, and back around to complete the circuit. And you can see at the output, we see just that highest voltage coming through. Next is the third stage, and this is where B, the red line, becomes the highest. And that's from here to here. You can see the other voltages are lower. Since B is highest, current is going to go through and flow through diode 2 to our load, and then back around to close the circuit. In short, we have three sources equally spaced, balanced, and they're going through these three diodes. And you can see during the phases when each one is the highest, only that voltage is seen at the output over the load. And so we get from an AC source, we get an approximately DC. There's still some ripple in there, but it's a good approximation. So we can go from an AC to a DC using a three-phase half-wave rectifier in this way.